new view of matter, or an ancient one regained, only a new view of what matters will break the trap pattern.
San Francisco. It's 2 a.m. The cellar is closing for the night. I hear the whisper of a just opened after hours jam.
I have nothing against poets, but I'm not a fan.
Testing, yeah. How's that?
Sounds good.
Hello? Bees, be a saint. It's time for transformation.
Yeah.
Absorb this information. Enter your potential. It's vital, essential. It is the late 50s. Bob Kaufman is standing on Grant and Green in front of the Coexistence Bagel Shop. He's watching a shadow play, his shadow in the noonday sun. Another shadow, the cop on the beat. Beat the system, be attitude. Attitude, beatific.
During the beat era, the Eastern influence was very strong, so there was a lot of writing in the Japanese form of the haiku and the senru. A lot of prose poetry came out at that time. So the stream of consciousness, in other words, just letting your mind just go and just flow without editing. And every one of these poets wrote a completely different styles in different ways. I mean, that's why there is no such thing as beatnik poetry.
When I grew up, and you know, I was a teen, I always say I was a teen beat, because I would go across the street and press my nose against the window and look at the beatniks inside.
None of us called ourselves beatniks. But then all the ramifications of what you can do with that word, the beat, which is the rhythm, and being beaten down, and beatitude, which is a holy kind of thing, which is something that especially Bob Kaufman very much expounded on.
And if you didn't know him, you would just think he was a wino. I mean, he was drunk a lot of the time, or under some influence.
He died in 1986, and he was black, and he was also Jewish. He started this magazine called Beatitude back in 59, and it was kind of done on mimeograph and put it out every week, and there was no editing on it. Whoever brought poems, it was in there. And all the famous people are in there. I mean, they just brought their poems, like Kerouac and Ginsberg and Ferlinghetti. They're all in those first mimeographed issues of that magazine, Beatitude.
Henry Lenoir, from what one person told me, wouldn't have allowed Jack Kerouac in here if he saw him. Now, he wasn't always here, so.
What's funny is most of the time he actually traveled in a car, so he was still going back and forth across the country. Especially with Neil Cassidy. He didn't do that much hitchhiking, whereas I went mostly around the country hitchhiking.
I ran into Ginsberg and I ran into Cassidy and cooked him dinner when I was 18 years old. That was 1967, and I was going, what about Kerouac? And Ginsberg goes, he's living with his mother in Florida, you know. And they really didn't, and Cassidy was pretty much gone, you know. He was going, I've seen these walls before, you know, so.
For a short time, and that was before he rode on the road, he would come by to where I lived, and we'd drink together, and we were never lovers, that's why I say. He treated me, you know, like a friend. He didn't treat his women too well. But we were good friends in the short time, and we would stay up all night and write haiku.
A number of them were bad drunks. There's a permanent 86 list here that lists some of the later ones that were still here when I moved to the neighborhood. And I see no reason to believe the earlier ones were any different, awesome. So.
I think that there are certain names that of certain people, I won't mention them again to add fuel to this, and I'm sure everybody knows them all over the world, who managed to get their names out again and again, and who were very good with the media. And I applaud them for that, because I didn't have that kind of know-how. And especially the women were always put in the back. It was a horrible time, and I think this was a reaction. Also, right after the war, there was this huge wave of materialism coming in, you know, because before the war there had been the Depression, and I think there was a rebellion by young people who were, you know, is this what life is about? There's more to it than that. But it was also a dark time, and it was kind of a ironic sense of humor. What today maybe is known as Gothic. I wore black, it was not, you know. It wasn't a uniform, we just felt comfortable wearing black. And maybe dark glasses, a lot of rebellion, a lot of smoking marijuana. It's just come out recently that things I've done, like paint my room all black or shave my hair. I shaved my head back in 65. There was a lot of anger, and there was a lot of hurt, and there was a lot of pain.
Besides being from the beat era of the poetry, I'm also a refugee from the Holocaust, the Nazi one. And I was invited back to Vienna, where I grew up, to participate in a memorial for the Holocaust. And this is what I wrote for it. And it's called, Her Number Was Not Called. Her number was not called. Her number was not called. She was not there to be given a number. She was 10. She sails away. Her doll's head breaks in the storm as it crashes to the floor. Salt of the sea mixes with tears that do not return. She's 20. Lives in a room she paints black. Vomits daily for 20 years. Shaves her head. Does not know why she's alive. Does not know the source of her pain. She is 65. A light beams the tunnel. She freezes in panic. A voice with questions. A voice from the heart. We're here to gather the stories from the Holocaust. My story? My number was not called. I was not there to be given a number. I have no tattoo to show you. But you are here. Yes, I am here. I left with mother and father, all the others, cousin, aunt, uncle, mother of my mother, all the others, into gas and smoke. A light at the end of the tunnel. A light at the end of the tunnel. All the letters become letters of gold. Honor the memory, then let go of the pain to keep it from happening again and again. This is the beginning.
There's one thing I can tell you, I've never been bored. I don't know what that word means. I mean, I need more and more time for all the things that I'm... And I found people with sparkling minds and great communications.
Let's give it up for Ruth Weiss.
There are no strangers, you know, and it's exciting. I think life is more exciting than ever. Yeah. And I still have many of the challenges I had as a young person. Believe me, I have not all the answers. In fact, I'm barely beginning to ask the right questions.
Make waves. Make waves. See the picture you want to see. See the picture in your dream. See the picture in awake. see the picture you want to see. Relax. Oh. Accept. Take the energy and get a move on. Mm-hmm.